Filipino-Canadians are aware that Bongbong Marcos is leading the surveys in the vice presidential race. They know Marcos is strong among the Filipino millennials. UBC Professor Leonora Angeles is not surprised.
Our social memory as a people can be very faulty, especially with regards to the youth who really have very little sense of what happened during martial law years.
Angeles says most of the youth were not born yet when the Marcoses were ousted from power and have no recollection of the abuses then. She calls on kababayans not to engage in any kind of historical revisionism, adding the record should be set straight. During her visit to Vancouver, Lloyda Nicolas Lewis, chair of the U.S. Pinoys for Good Governance, says Marcos should not deny any knowledge of the past.
He was a teenager, he was 21, 22. Alam niyang mga ginawa niyang mga kalokohan.
But Marcos supporter Carmelita Tapia sees otherwise. Tapia says Filipinos should not also forget the positive things the Marcoses did for the country. She adds Pinoy voters should not be afraid if Marcos wins as vice president.
The sins of the father, hindi mo dapat na ibuntun sa anak. Let us give him the benefit of the doubt.
It mind boggles me. How could you move on? How could you expect people to give you the benefit of the doubt if you yourself are in denial of what really happened?
Filipino-Canadian Amado Mercado remembers those years. Mercado attended pro-democracy rallies during his grade school years in Ateneo. As a dual citizen, he is exercising his right to vote. Mercado says Marcos has to apologize for his family's misdeeds before moving on. He also hopes the millennials will vote wisely as this year's election is very critical to the country.
This election will dictate the next 12 to 20 years of how the Philippines will be like for our people, for our children, for our future leaders.
Cecile Docto, ABS-CBN News, Vancouver.